sense. So we develop another approach, and for this there is an Eulerian approach and a Lagrangian approach. When you do models and comparamental models, people move and they mix like particles. Then I lose track of people. An Eulerian approach is this guy is resident here, it always remains resident up here. This is resident here, this is always resident here. So how do we model that? Well, for each individual and that, this is P12 is the proportion of times that residents of patch one spend in patch two. The other one is patch two spend in patch one, and the others are the obvious. So we use residence times matrices, and we can write differential equations. And then I say, who are the residents in patch I? I visited South Africa, and I went to Soweto and Johannesburg. Johannesburg has about 1.5 million, and Soweto probably has a similar number of people. Okay? But every day in the morning, probably 500,000 of people from Soweto goes to work to Johannesburg. Right? And what happens when they go to work? So what is the population of Johannesburg? 1.5 million or 2 million? Okay? I think that they had another class.
Yeah,
okay. So anyway, so if we do that, we can write models like that, and we can compute the basic reproductive number, and we can study epidemics by risk area rather than by rate of growth and rather than by contacts. And I developed a theory for that. I thank you for your patience. I'm sorry about that.
Okay, thank you.